कैन वी से थिंग्स और अब्यूज इस्लाम लाइक द वे वी अब्यूज हिंदुत्व? इफ वी डू वील बी थ्रोन इन जेल, वी नो दैट. व्हाई आर पीपल प्रोसिक्यूटेड फॉर अब्यूजिंग इस्लाम बट नॉट अब्यूजिंग हिंदुत्व? राइट टू एजुकेशन दैट इज वर्किंग इन कंजंक्शन विद द 93rd अमेंडमेंट दैट पुट्स द ओनस ओनली ऑन हिंदू रन स्कूल्स टू ऑफर 25% रिजर्वेशन फॉर द इकोनॉमिकली वीकर सेक्शन. द माइनॉरिटी रन स्कूल्स डू नॉट हैव टू ओबे टू दैट डिक्टेट. आई एम जस्ट टॉकिंग अबाउट दीज आर कॉमन सेंसिकल प्लेन लॉजिकल एंड रैशनल डिस्क्रिमिनेशंस दैट आर हैपनिंग. एंड इफ फॉर द लास्ट 10 इयर्स यू आर नॉट एबल टू रिमूव देम, डू यू प्लान विद मैसिव मेजॉरिटी यू प्लान टू रिमूव देम विद अ कोलिशन गवर्नमेंट? कपल ऑफ अदर पॉइंट्स अबाउट हिंदुत्व स्पेशली. वी लिव इन अ कंट्री वेयर वी हैव लॉज, फॉर एग्जाम्पल सेक्शन 295A दैट प्रोसिक्यूट्स एंड अरेस्ट पीपल फॉर ऑफेंडिंग रिलीजियस सेंसिबिलिटीज, एंड दिस इज ऑलवेज सब्जेक्टिव. वॉट इज ऑफेंस, वॉट इज नॉट. फॉर एग्जाम्पल वॉट उदयनिधि स्टालिन सेड वॉन्टिंग टू इरेडिकेट सनातन धर्म एंड ही इज स्टिल रोमिंग फ्री. Whereas one 20-year-old, I think, boy from Maharashtra who advocated people not to go to Ajmer Dargah, he was thrown in jail because he offended the religious sensibilities of Muslims. And no newspaper or media covered it. They covered it only after he emerged from jail after 45 days. This is the country. And even though the Supreme Court judgment says that the state police must take immediate action if somebody offends religious sensibilities, file an FIR, file a case, Tamil Nadu, obviously, police did not file a case against Udayanidhi Stalin. So this is a subjective matter. Can we say things or abuse Islam like the way we abuse Hindutva? If we do, we'll be thrown in jail. We know that. So why do Hindus accept when the left and the Islamists and the non-Hindus abuse this word or this philosophy, Hindutva, rampantly? They do it because they actually mean to abuse Hindus or Hinduism, but if they do so, they run the risk of offending religious sensibility. So they found this nice kind of detour that they will, the whatever abuse they want to shower on Hinduism, they use the word Hindutva. But besides the fact that there is a 1995 Supreme Court judgment where the Chief Justice at that point of time was hailed as the panacea of liberalism, Justice Verma, he says Hindutva is the essence of Hinduism. It is what Hinduism is. And that judgment was based on the teachings of a lot of other Hindu philosophers as well. Radhakrishnan, yes, being one, Ramakrishna, Paramhans being another. So I want to ask, as a free speech absolutist, I don't want 295 to be there, but in the time it is there, why are people prosecuted for abusing Islam but not abusing Hindutva? Especially when I have thrown this a challenge, name me five things for people who deride Hindutva. Name me five things that are there in Hindutva that aren't already there in Islam. Five. Just five. Open challenge. And if you can't, will you deride Islam as much as you deride Hindutva? No one has been able to answer this. So it is clear the hate towards Hindutva is essentially a hate towards Hindus and Hinduism. They've just found this stopgap, and our government, our lawyers, our judges are absolutely quiet about it. I think a lot of this Hindu phobia would end if this fork that has been provided to these bigots is realized, first of all, by the Supreme Court. But then when the Supreme Court stays silent when Udayanidhi Stalin abuses Hinduism, why would it speak out when somebody abuses Hindutva? You know, when you are perpetually asked to rise up as a people's movement, you know, to take back what is wrong, to fight for your rights, there's only so much people can do, because we are all working, we're all doing our jobs. This is not our job. The job of the people is to elect an entity that promises to correct injustices. We are not, a billion of us are not judges, you know, a billion of us are not policy makers. When our governments don't correct those, when our governments keep on rearming religions that are out to destroy Hinduism. Just yesterday, I don't know how correct this news is, that the Maharashtra BJP coalition government has provided 20 crores, it is, to the Waqf board, 10 crores to the Waqf board. What's going on out here? You have the minority ministry under the BJP in the last 10 years. First of all, why on earth should this minority ministry exist? But it does. And it offers interest-free loans to anyone who wants to set up a shop on Waqf land. Now, would they be Hindus who would set up shops on Waqf land? They are provided interest-free loans. You have RTE, Right to Education, that is working in conjunction with the 93rd Amendment that puts the onus only on Hindu-run schools to offer 25% reservation for the economically weaker sections. The minority-run schools do not have to obey to that diktat. No one is asking for appeasement. People are asking to remove the discrimination that is happening against Hindus and Hinduism. I'm not even going to Hindu temples. I'm not going to Place of Worship Act. I'm not going to the draconian nature of many legislations or the Waqf Act. I'm just talking about these are commonsensical, plain, logical and rational discriminations that are happening. And if for the last 10 years, you're not able to remove them, do you plan with massive majority, you plan to remove them with a coalition government?
Thank you, Anand.